monsters and all the parts of the mills inside them.
And enjoy a township cruise experience with Ben Hall and crew today.
So if you like the idea of hoisting sail on board a mega yacht and sailing off into the sunset, please step on board.
That's all new in August on Travel Channel. When it comes to luxury travel, Baron Sherman is all about the numbers.
1,000 different labels.
175 guest rooms, 170 square meters, 90 square meters in area, 60 suites, 46 degrees centigrade. Sits 8 comfortably. Number 6.
4 kilometers. Out there.
2 guest bedrooms, only 1. Baron Sherman. Inside luxury travel on Travel Channel.
On the banks of the Volta lies Prague, the magnificent city of 100 spires. In the 14th century, the Roman Emperor Charles IV elected it as his place of residence and commissioned many buildings. He assigned the architect Peter Parler to build Charles Bridge across the river. In the middle, St. John of Nepomuk is still an object of veneration. The martyr perished after being thrown from the bridge on the order of Venceslaus IV. The historic center of Prague is located on Broad County Hill. Kafka's castle really exists. The seat of royal power from 1158, monarchs and architectural styles changed until flamboyant Gothic. St. Vitus's Cathedral began in 1344 and completed only in the 20th century, was also commissioned by Charles IV. Entered through the Golden Gate, surmounted by a Venetian mosaic. Inside, the proportions of the choir were inspired by French art. The monumental edifice is bathed in light. The cathedral contains several royal tombs, including that of good King Venceslaus, murdered on the 28th of September, 935, on his brother's orders. According to legend, the dying king grasped this bronze ring. In the late 16th century, the rise to power of Rudolf II, Count of Habsburg, ushered in a major architectural shift. Prague embraced the Baroque Age. The district of Malostrana was a part of this artistic revival. In the town hall square, the arts flourished. Illustrious astronomers Kepler and Tycho Brahe, attracted by the prestige of this city, admired the astronomical clock built in 1410. In this city, inscribed on UNESCO's World Heritage List in 1992, only the clock shows the passage of time.
this day, another fascinating destination. This time, we're in Puerto Limon, on the east coast of Costa Rica. We're being taken to have a ride on a restored railway that's only just been reopened after a disastrous flood. The track runs through banana plantations into natural rainforest, where we're promised an intimate view of some of the country's diverse wildlife. Our destination is the famous reserve of the Tortuguero Canals, but the trip getting us there is pretty good too.
Well, we're taking a ride off the blue banana train in Costa Rica. It's well known as we'll discover, because I've got Corina here, who's a local tour guide. She's got a bit of information about this train. Tell me, first of all, why was the railway built?
Well, the railroad was done to find a closer way to export the coffee to Europe. So it was very necessary. Coffee exportation was growing, but we had no access to the Caribbean coast. So they had to bring all the coffee from the central part of the country, where it grows, where we have very rich volcanic soil, down to the west coast. And they had to ship it down at the Cape Horn all the way to Europe. So we needed an alternative to bring this coffee closer to the Caribbean coast. So they started the project of the railroad. Well, they started with the railroad in 1871. And so they brought all material from North America to the west coast of the first mountain chain, and then they started from the Central Valley down to Limon.
And this was in 1871?
Yeah.
Long time ago.
It took 19 years to build the railroad. Many people died in the construction of the railroad. So they rode in black
Papa.
Railroad. That's why we have so much African
people
in Costa Rica since the construction of the railroad.
Say about that?
Caribbean banana plantation.
Yeah, thank you.
The cost of the railroad. That's why we have